Hello, guys. I hope you are blessed today. I wanted to share a quick word from Genesis. You remember the story of Joseph? He was sort of a daddy's boy, I guess. Remember he got the coat of many colors? Remember he had some prophetic dreams that his brothers and his parents were going to bow down and worship him? And remember it started to stir up this animosity between him and his brothers. And one day, remember, his dad tells him to go down and check on his brothers in the field, check on the flocks. So he goes down there, and as he heads down, the brothers say, oh, here comes that dreamer. And they plot against him, and they decide to kill him. And then the nice brother says, no, let's not kill him. Let's throw him in this hole instead. Remember, so they throw him in this well, and then along come these slave traders. And so Joseph's brothers sell him to the slave traders. And you'll remember that Joseph gets sold into the house of Potiphar. And as time goes on, he becomes a trusted servant, and he rises up in Potiphar's household until he becomes the head of the household. And you remember the whole debacle with Potiphar's wife, and Joseph is accused of rape, and he's thrown into prison. And over time, Joseph rises to power. He shows his faithfulness and consistency in prison. And before long, he's running the prison. The prisoner is running the prison. And I remember in a strange turn of events, one day Joseph goes from being in prison to being the prime minister of Egypt, the most powerful nation on earth. And I remember not too long after that, a severe famine strikes the land. And Joseph's brothers have to come to Egypt to try to get some grain to sustain their families and their flocks. And I remember when they show up, Joseph is having this encounter with them. And initially they don't recognize Joseph, because Joseph, he looks like an Egyptian, he acts like an Egyptian, he talks like an Egyptian. And so they don't recognize him at first. And towards the end of the story, Joseph finally reveals himself. And when he does, his brothers are terrified. They're afraid. They say, look, we tried to kill our brother, and now he's the most powerful man in the world, the second most powerful man in the world. He's going to avenge himself. He's gonna take revenge on us. And Joseph says to them in Genesis chapter 50, verse 20, as for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good, to bring it about that many people should be kept alive as they are today. And I really like that. And I want you to see this. There are people in this life, there are people in this world who have wronged you. There are people who have conspired against you. You know, we as believers, we all have the world, the flesh, and the devil all warring against our souls, right? We have this evil trinity trying to do us ill. And I don't mean ill in the cool Beastie Boys sort of way, right? They're looking to do us harm. They want to hurt us. But do you know what? We have a God who is bigger than that. We have a God who works all things together for good, for those who love him and are called according to his name. And so I hope that you can take peace in that. You can take solace in that. That troubles might come your way. Things might happen in life that you don't understand. But take solace in this fact, that God is sovereign, that God is in control, that God is bigger than our issues. As I've said so many times recently, God still sits on the throne. He's in control and he loves you. So I hope that you can just rest in that today, and that you can enter into his peace as you meditate on that. God bless.